by helping them. So counseling can be directive or non-directive. Directive would be where we guide them, and non-directive would be provide them the tools and ask them to help themselves. Rapport building is very essential in counseling. Rapport building can be done in various ways. It can be emotional aspect of it is very important, where the counselor has to be completely accepting of the client and be non-judgmental. Since a lot of communication happens through our body language, so that plays a very important role. The tone of voice plays an important role. And some importance of words are also there. Apart from that, even small things like, you know, your qualification or any referrals that you have, or anything that makes you appear more qualified for the position also helps build rapport, makes the client feel confident about you, that you can help them. Even kinesthetically or connecting in a same energy field, probably, you know, smiling at the client or kind of being in the same, you know, zone kind of where the client is. Apart from that, various values of the counselor is important. Like I said, you know, being non-judgmental, smiling at the client appropriate is important.
Okay,
strokes,
Anita,
is something that
Anita, yeah. It's very nice. Actually, I want you to tell from your perspective. Okay, you are dealing many cases. Okay, you are preparing what you call counseling reports. You are preparing, isn't it? So, yes. Can you tell exactly when you in a clinical setup, when you do counseling? Okay, what are the procedures you are you will be doing? Because that will be much more important to people. People would have not been, yes, in the clinical setup. So you are working in a clinical, okay, setup now. So when a client comes, what are the different aspects you will be doing? Like what are the things you will write, project taking, okay, all those things. Yeah.
Okay. So once a client has come to us, the first thing that we do is take the history of the client. Initially, we start with just making the client speak about what is, you know, happening with them. So the client will probably speak about the problem. And as a counselor and therapist, we need to be completely, you know, not active at this point. Let the client take the role and speak. And we need to listen to them non-judgmentally, and very active listening skills comes in use here. Even paraphrasing, that is, you know, using main words from or main aspect from them and giving it back to them, so that we understand and the client understands that we are on the same page. They feel more understood by that. So paraphrasing is an important quality. Going back in the history is also something that we do. Knowing about the family history, academic history, childhood history, if anything was wrong there, if the person has friends or support system like family members or any co-workers. Also knowing history about the workplace. Apart from that, something that is very important is also risk assessment, where we'll see whether any client is more prone to suicidal ideations is something that's important. So if we get a client who's probably more on a depressive side, who shows symptoms of depression, like, you know, appetite loss, increased sleep or sleep, loss of interest in activities, then risk assessment is very important. So after all of these things is done, probably knowing the goal that the client, you know, wants to set at the start itself, and then developing an insight is something that I personally do at the start. I also, so since I've learned, I'm doing a course with Sir, so I also now recently use a lot lot of calming techniques. Like I tell them about the triune brain theory, and with that I make them understand about the the survival and the parts of the segments of the brain and each responsible for each, and how people are more emotional, and because of that a lot of problems happen. So initially what I do now because of this course is I also infuse a lot of them to do some calming techniques, so breathing techniques that I give them, and I give them a grounding exercise technique which helps them, and I've seen this work a lot. So a lot of times my clients randomly call me and say that I need an appointment right now. So what I do is I say okay to them, but I say before you do that, just do this thing for me. Just take a have a glass of water and do some breathing exercise. I'll give them a video, yeah, and I ask them to do the breathing exercise. What I do is usually a 4-4-4 technique. So breathe in for 4 seconds, hold your breath for 4, and breathe out for 4. Or sometimes 4-7-8. So there are many breathing techniques that we can look up to. So then after that, I give them the grounding exercise. Grounding exercise is very simple. 5 things you can see around you. 4 things that you can touch. 3 can hear. 2 things that you can... see or something, and one last thing is where you can smell. And last thing is where you can taste. So after this, there's a lot many people who actually automatically feel more in control. It's something that I've seen. So the problems that and then they don't really need that immediate help, that is initially. So after that, the goal setting is done, and then we explore as we go along. We explore things, and different techniques is used. Sometimes CBT is used, being non-judgmental is used. Sometimes insight building, okay, how is this thought helping you? Is this thought real? Is there an evidence for this thought? More of that. Sometimes relaxation technique with that. Sometimes visualization. So something like this.
Super. Thank you, Anita. It was very nice, because we wanted to take things from the first hand, because you are doing it on a day-to-day basis. So team, let us go to anchoring, because many people they were not very clear about anchoring. So anchoring, it is one procedure in NLP wherein we try to create a stimuli. See, the stimuli can be visual or kinesthetic or words. Okay, 3 kinds of stimuli we can create to get into a associated feeling. For example, in Circle of Excellence, what we did was we tried to create a visual aspect. Okay, we tried to create a visual aspect. And we try to create, at the end of the Circle of Excellence, I asked you people to tell a word, okay? So that is auditory. But we all know that kinesthetic is much more important than auditory and visual. Because some people say body kinesthetic is 55% and auditory and other aspects it's 45%. But some people say it is 70% kinesthetic, 27% the way your tone, and 3% 20 words. Okay, but whatever said and done, kinesthetic is more. When kinesthetic is more, kinesthetic anchoring works more. Okay, so what we are going to do is we will be creating we will be asking the client to recollect any good aspect. Okay, we used to ask the client, what is the one thing which made you to feel that you're top of the world? This we used to ask them, and after asking them, we used to use the VAK method, completely recollect in its entirety. Okay, after recollecting it, the same thing we used to anchor it through this finger, that is pressing this. Now this anchoring, this is being used by many people. Now let us see a small video of this. Okay, I think most people would have seen it. I do not know whether you have seen it or not. So I am just putting the video for all of you. So actually, the anchoring process, anchoring is being done by everyone. Anchoring is unconscious anchoring, everybody does. For example, few people, they always wear a particular dress when they go out. That is anchoring for them. Before going to interview, they used to pray some particular God. Okay, that is anchoring for them. So like that, many people have unconscious anchoring. For example, Malinga, he kisses the he'll be wearing a chain and he'll be kissing the chain. Okay, that is anchoring for him. So there are many anchoring like this. Now anchoring is being used in sports more. Okay, so let us see a small video. Now you can see you will be tapping the foot. NLP anchoring for sport with Jimmy. Tapping foot on the floor. So you can see he is tapping it. That is kinesthetic, that is anchoring for him. Okay, Ji. So this is what actually anchoring being used in sports, anchoring being used in many areas. Okay, particularly anchoring has been used by American politicians. Michael Obama is one person who was using this NLP and NLP techniques, and particularly this anchoring and all when he goes for any kind of meeting. I will share with you the photos, etc., in the WhatsApp. So anchoring is nothing but recollecting stimuli which created success for us and associating that particular moment with this sign, okay, either with this sign or with this sign. That is kinesthetic. Program it in the brain. And when we go for any particular aspect, suppose if I program this for self-confidence, earlier what I have achieved in my life through self-confidence, any one aspect will be there. And anchor this in this term. When I'm going for interview, just when I press this, the brain will get triggered. So now we are all listening to this. Suppose if I say death, dead body, night, 12 o'clock, dead body with a foul smell. See, now when I'm talking this, something negative happens in the body. Hey, why? Shiva is talking all these things here in the car. Night, I have to sleep here. What is this? Like that you may be thinking. Now, why? That is triggering something. That is triggering something in my brain. So if we stimulate, the positive aspects, definitely that is going to be triggered. Actually, this is actually an experiment conducted by Pavlov that all our psychology students may be knowing. But this is one extension. But this is having some other relevance also anchored as far as counseling is concerned. Now, the people who come for counseling, they would have anchored some negative aspects. Now, let us have a quick chat here. Okay, so, Chavi, whether you are able to talk today, whether your line is okay today?
I'm there. Can you hear me?
Yeah, it's 100% audible, Chavi. Okay, Chavi. There are times, okay, we used to tell, see, I do not know why, but I don't like a particular person, isn't it? There are some people used to tell, see, why can't you go and talk with that person? Hey, I don't like that person here. Hey, what has happened? I do not know why here, but I don't like that person. There are many people tell like this. What is your view on this?
Yeah, it happens.
Yeah. So, can you name someone who's told like this to you that I don't like this person? Any incident like that?
There has been a colleague. I have found her to be very vengeful. Like even for tiniest of things that many people would let go of thinking benefit of doubt to the other person that the person did intentionally. He would hold a grudge and make sure that I have, not that she did it to me, but I've observed her doing it with other people, so that made a vibe against her in my head.
Yeah, so that is what anchoring, unconscious anchoring. Unconsciously, I made a program in my mind that that person is like that. Now, what happens, whenever I see the person again, that gets triggered. That gets triggered and we will do the same aspect again and again. So this is having a very great impact in the counseling. One is using the anchoring for self-development. In self-development, what we are going to do is, we are going to recollect some positive event which happened in our life and we are going to anchor it by doing like this. And when I'm going to present, when I'm going to do some public talking, public speech, when I go for some training, I'm going to press this. When I press this, it triggers a positive element in my brain and oxytocin is released, endorphins are released. Because of this oxytocin and endorphins is released in the body, I will be feeling so confident. Now, the opposite is, someone is going to talk in public. The moment they go, if they feel fear, means adrenaline is triggered. The body produces more adrenaline when they get into stress. So opposite is, when I press this, endorphins and oxytocin starts releasing. So I feel like talking very nicely and I'll be spontaneous in delivering my speech. This is one aspect as far as to improve our self-confidence. The other aspect of anchoring is, in the counseling hall, when a client comes to us, we have to see whether he is having any unconscious anchoring. whether any unconscious anchoring is playing in his life or in his talk, whatever he says, is it true or it is because of the unconscious anchoring that this person is like this one. This, everyone who is in the counseling, they might have seen this, okay? So, shall we have someone who is doing counseling regularly? Yeah, Roshini, can you come online? Otherwise, shall we have...
Can you be able to hear me?
Yeah.
Able to hear me?
Yes. Your voice is audible.
Yeah, sir. So when I was doing my counseling regularly with the clients, mainly I'll be doing with the addiction patients.
So have you and seen this?
Can you able to hear me, sir?
Yes, go ahead. Have you ever seen this kind of unconscious anchoring?
Yeah. I've seen, sir. I have seen in many patients. Mostly when they are addicted with any kind of substance, they couldn't able to feel like they are in the present mode, and they have their own way of doing the anchoring style. And even when you are saying that, I can relate to one of the patient where he used to hold his hands together whenever he is talking to someone else.
Okay, that's that is one thing. So, team, you will be really you will be able to correlate now that this unconscious anchoring with clients. Okay, it will be you will be able to see more. Can anyone else share any kind of unconscious anchoring which you people have seen? For example, the moment someone touches the cigarette now like this, okay, this like this, they will touch. Now this touch now for some people, this touch is an anchor. It is not the smoking which creates them a pleasant experience. Holding the cigarette like this, kinesthetic, that creates some kind of euphoria. In some of the cases, I have found that only by holding, instead of holding a cigarette, suppose if they hold a pencil like this, na, what happens? They get the same vibe. That means kinesthetic. This is unconscious anchoring. So when we start replacing the cigarette with something else, which can replace the anchoring, okay, then definitely he will come out of smoking. Okay, this we have seen it in one or two cases. This kind of unconscious anchoring. Can anyone share any other unconscious anchoring which you have seen in clients? For some people, even the smell of the alcohol, that is anchoring. So for them, it is not drinking alcohol. Okay, they will see, they will tell, one person told, sir, the mere smell, that is enough for me, sir. Now the best thing is, okay, for you, the smell is enough, na? Now, only with the smell itself, 2 or 3 days, 4 days, he will be able to prolong it. That means he can slowly come out without drinking. Even by taking the smell itself, we can anchor that and he will be able to come out slowly. So is there any other unconscious anchoring which you can, which people can share?
So, Shiva sir, I would like to say something on this. So that's, this is about, so this is about me, myself, actually. And I didn't realize it after people started telling me. So whenever I'm doing any kind of a training session or I'm addressing a crowd, I used to always hold a bottle of water. And not that I'm sipping that water thing, that bottle of small Bisleri bottle was constantly there. So I used to put my mic on, which was cordless mic. So there was once an instance in Delhi when I had to address and the cordless mic was not working and they gave me a normal mic. So I had a mic, I had a bottle, and I used a lot of hand expressions to talk. And suddenly I felt that there are too many things in my hands. And that's when I realized that, oh shit, I operate without this bottle. And that was the time I realized that I have to take a conscious effort to leave that bottle, but I still use it for last 15 years I'm using. So I cannot talk without that bottle actually.
See, when you're telling, I am recollecting one of my boss, okay? His name is Prakash Reddy, okay? His name is Prakash Reddy. Whenever he goes for a call, he takes the water bottle, okay? When he talks with the client, he will be holding the water bottle. This I have seen it many times. And I have asked him, sir, why are you holding that water bottle always? He used to tell, Shukumar, this, I feel that when I'm holding this, okay, I feel some kind of confidence and I feel that the success, the sales call will be very nice. And I have never seen him talking with clients without a bottle, that is particularly yellow color bottle. Yellow color
Even I have that particular bottle now. But last few years, I've switched to a steel flask. There's a thin steel flask. Okay. So all my pictures with on the dashboard is there with that bottle in my hand.
So team, actually, this is unconscious anchoring. In the client, in the counseling, all we have to see what is the unconscious anchoring they have, and if we separate the outcome and the thing, okay? For example, smell, that is the input. Output is getting, he feels very nice. So the output and the behavior, if we are able to separate, and if we are able to give that output with some other input, okay, then the counseling is going to be successful. As far as counseling is concerned, as far as our own life is concerned, we can always do anchoring to improve our self-confidence in various areas. So today night, I will be sharing you now, immediately now, in 2 minutes, the call is going to get over. I will be sharing in the counseling room as well as in the NLP group. I will share you the audio for reframing. Now we are going to reframe procrastination, everyone, okay? Because every one of us, we procrastinate a lot, okay? I procrastinate, I also procrastinate some of the time. Everyone, okay, at some point of time, we procrastinate something. So we will take procrastination as the thing which we have to reframe it, okay? Now play the audio and just listen to it. That is 6-step reframing. Yesterday what we talked, that is what you are going to do it now. The moment the call ends, I will be sharing the audio in the group. Kindly play the audio and do it and tell me the response. Now when you are doing it your own self, you have to see that the unconscious is talking with you. The unconscious is connected and he is showing the gesture that you should be able to feel your own self. Because when you are doing counseling, you will be able to see in the client, as I told you, slightly it will go up, okay? But in your own case, you can just build up the hand. There is some kind of sensation you will be able to feel in the body. If you feel any kind of sensation in the body, when you are asking the other part, that means the unconscious part started talking with you, okay? And if at all you want to experience your unconscious, already I told you, already we did exercise, feel that you are standing on a 600 feet building and you are looking down. Think for 1 minute and you will feel that the unconscious is coming out, okay? You'll be able to feel the unconscious. So reframing, now we are going to do it, okay? As far as anchoring is concerned, I'll be sharing the PPT. Go through the PPT. For reframe also, I will share the PPT. Okay? Go through it. So we will be doing reframing now. And the other one, we will be doing the exercise tomorrow. Okay? So today we have many people on video. We have Newton ma'am. Thank you, Newton ma'am. And we have...
Thank you, Shiva. I'm overwhelmed.
Thank you. And we have Darshini.
Thank you, everyone. Yeah. Thank you, everyone. Yeah.
So we have two set of people in this group, okay? One is 64 years young, okay? And one is 16 years young, okay? We have Darshini here, yeah? Okay? Youngest NLP participant. And we have to clap for her. The moment of interest she is taking. Even though she is studying in 9th standard, okay, She takes much stress, okay. And definitely we have to clap our hands for Darshini. Great.
God bless you. God bless.
God bless
thank
you.
Thank you.
Thank you. So, thank team, you. Thank you very much, team. Let us thank assemble you. In the group, both the groups in counseling group and industry group. Thank you very much, team. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.